It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares. Our Gallagher. And our special tribute to Leave It to Beaver. With Ken Osmond. As Mr. Oliver. Rich Corral as Richard. And Jerry Mathers as the Beaver. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
Gene Lumpy Raver.
Right.
John Beaver Bauman.
Hey, listen, for eight people, they're making a lot of noise, aren't they?
They are courageous.
All right, thank you, NBC, for the mob. And now, would the mob join John and me in saying hello to the stars of Leave It to Beaver and Gallagher?
Hit it, Bob!
Can you believe this guy?
This guy is so
now Gallagher. What are you doing?
He's so weird.
So, talk to me again.
Well, he's just so weird.
He's so weird. Go ahead.
What do you think? So weird.
I had to do
something
different.
How weird was he? What do you? What is the name of your character?
That's my half sister.
Ah.
You know, Gene, I like Gallagher, but he's kind of two-faced, don't you think?
He's kind of two-faced.
Okay, that's all the jokes. I took it off.
Oh, no, right. There'll be more of that. Are you a gentleman?
They'll do as well as they cheer.
Yeah. We've had, is this the first time we've had an all-male panel?
Yes, it is.
All right. Use your deepest voice, and we'll go on and say hello to our two players over here. Rick Hoffman and Jerry Kimber. Welcome. Rick, tell us a little bit about you, please.
I'm married and I have four children. I live in Los Alamitos and I'm a Seal Beach policeman.
You are?
Yes.
Seal Beach.
Yeah.
There you go.
It's just south of Long Beach.
Oh, yes. Right. That's a beautiful area.
Yes, it is.
Get much smog there?
None. None at all.
Good. Because it's a little bad here today. Nothing personal, Los Angeles. Jerry, tell us about you, please.
Well, I've been married 14 years to a policeman. I have two little boys.
Yeah?
And I own and operate an automotive repair business.
Right. Are you married to this policeman?
No.
And you're an auto mechanic?
I better not be.
You're an auto mechanic?
I'm not a mechanic. I own and operate. I run the store.
Oh, you run the store?
Oh, yeah.
They don't pull anything funny on me.
They don't?
No.
Why not?
Because I know what they're doing.
Ah. Who's minding the store while you're here?
I'm afraid it's going downhill.
Oh, well... You better win some money, so we better get going for you. All right, I'll push the button here. Well, anyway, before I push, the thing doesn't work. To hell with it. Listen, each of you will have three chances to match as many of the ding-a-lings as you can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. And that person will go on to challenge the returning champion on the Hollywood Squares part of it for a chance to win up to $30,000. Now, here we go. What is that? See that? I get my finger poised and it goes down all by itself. Holy mackerel. Oh!
The magic.
Hey, this is spooky, isn't it? This is very weird. This is magic.
How weird is it?
I'll tell you how weird it is. Bing, 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 bing. There it is. All right, Rick, you won the toss. You go first, A or B?
I'd like an A.
A it is. Here we go.
Okay.
In the middle of the storm, the co-pilot said to the... Or the pilot said to the co-pilot. These two guys were talking. The pilot said, I'm beginning to worry about our chances. I just called the air traffic controller, and he's blanking. I'm beginning to worry about our chances. I just called the air traffic controller, and he's blanking. Very good.
Okay, thanks.
Right. Good. Good.
Hey, Gene, what do you think about this? I invented this for people when they get drunk so they don't bump into doors and walls. What do you think?
How about that? Very good. Unicorn Gallagher.
Now, wait a minute. Put it on again.
No, it makes a big hickey on your forehead.
Now, put it on there.
Okay.
All right, now come over here.
Okay.
All right, now.
We'll try.
Get down on your knees.
Get down on my knees.
All right, now face that way.
Face that way.
Now, bend down a little more.
All right.
Run into this wall. See, it works. There. Did he hurt himself? No, he didn't hurt himself. It worked.
You're beginning to wonder, Gene.
This is what makes America strong.
Right. Okay, Rick, in the middle of the storm, the pilot said to the co-pilot, I'm beginning to worry about our chances. I just called the air traffic controller and he's blanking.
Gurgling.
What?
Gurgling.
He's gurgling.
He's gurgling.
Now listen, that is a booable answer.
That's so silly.
Right. You got it. Now, Rick, I realize I did refer to them as ding-a-lings or loonies or whatever it was.
But he matched us. He matched us. Perfect.
Now, ding-a-lingy as they are, I will guarantee you that not one of them said gurgling. I will guarantee that. Walk this way. Well, if I could walk that way. Hello, Richard.
Hi.
How are you?
Well, I'm sad with that answer. I mean, this isn't too bright, but
sleeping is good.
You know?
That's good. Sleeping is good. All right, Beaver.
Well, I thought he was really worried about him, so he started drinking.
Aha, drinking. Another good one?
I'm gurgling, though.
You got another one to contribute, a good one?
Good afternoon, Mr. Graper.
Good afternoon to you, sir.
I think the air traffic controller is quitting.
Aha!
Quitting.
Very good. Quitting. Okay, I just called the air traffic controller, and he's blanking, John.
This could just about sum up how you feel right now, Rick.
Crying. Rick, not a good answer there.
Nah, I felt that the guy was really worried, so that he was weeping.
Weeping!
Weeping is crying!
Weeping is crying. All right, so there it is. Well, there are some answers there that would have worked very well for you. Weeping, for instance, would have gotten you some. Now let's see if Jerry scores here.
He's got four kids.
Hey, I'll tell you why Ugly Edna's face looks the way it does. It happened after she tried to kiss a blank. That's why her face looks that ugly.
Get up, bum bum. Get up, bum bum bum.
Go. Big brother's watching.
Okay.
Yeah. Is this your real hair?
No, I got that from a ghost. Someone died and left it.
All right. Put that right in the slot there.
Okay, you're right.
Gallagher. Ready, ready, ready. Here we go. Jerry. I'll tell you why Ugly Edna's face looks the way it does. It happened after she tried to kiss a blank.
A lawnmower.
A lawnmower. Very imaginative answer. An imaginative answer if I've ever heard you. Thank you. Richard.
Well, she could get in real trouble with a blender.
That's right. That's another good one. Two good ones so far. No doubt you have a good one, Jerry.
A track shoe.
A track shoe.
Almost too close.
Now, wait a minute.
Hey, the beef is funny.
She loved her shoes.
I'm a little worried about the beaver.
Why?
No, he's funny.
He's
funny.
Someplace.
No, he's okay.
That's the line. I'm a little worried about. I'm worried about the beaver. Remember?
That's right. That's right. That's what the mother or the father would say. What do you say, Ken?
Listen, anybody would get ugly if they kissed a toad.
A toad, right?
There you go. That's right.
There you go. A lawnmower. Huh? Lawnmower is what she's after.
No help here, gorilla.
Yeah.
No,
but that's a good answer.
Yeah, the gorilla.
No, I wasn't as violent as a lawnmower. I took a blender. I was with
a blender.
Is that the same as a Vegemite?
No. I think so.
Hey,
it doesn't matter if you match him.
That's right. He's matched me real well.
They're going together. Yeah. Right. So here we are. Real tight battle going here. Zip to zip. We'll continue with round two right after this. Coming up. Bing. Round two. Now, since the score is tied and he went first last time, that means you have to go first this time.
A.
A?
A.
Okay. Jack said.
Jack?
Jack said the Tidy Bowl man has found a new way to amuse himself.
Uh-oh.
See, I don't know
the old way.
Yeah.
You don't know
we
the old way?
We don't know what to mark out, no.
Well, I just saw him, and he was blanking behind his boat. That's his new way of passing the time.
Passing the time.
Amusing himself. Yeah, right.
Behind the boat.
Can you tell me if this makes any sense?
We're ready for Jerry. Jack said the tidy bowl man has found a new way to amuse himself. I just saw him, and he was blanking behind his boat.
Skiing.
Skiing behind his boat. Very good. Great mind, right? Hello, Richard.
I guess I'm just too literal for this game. I said flushing.
Flushing behind his boat.
Liberal in for this
Long
game.
Island?
Yes, of course.
Yes.
What do you say?
Well, he's definitely going down the tubes, but I had to say he was skiing, too.
Yeah.
What else could he do behind the boat?
Okay. Kid Osmond.
You know, I tried to talk the kid into swapping with me because I like skiing better than I do swimming.
Swimming behind the boat.
That's right.
Another possibility. All right, Jerry's picked up one so far from the upper tier. Let's see how the lower tier treats her. John.
Pretty good so far.
Oh, what a skate!
All right. What did you say?
Well, I remember him as always paddling along, so I still said he was paddling behind
the boat. He was paddling behind the boat. All right, yeah. Jerry, you're up to two. Gallagher, do you make it three?
Well, this is an embarrassing answer. I didn't get the... I put blushing.
Blushing.
I was going for Richard, but I have more taste.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Not bloody much.
All right. All right. I agree. So it's two for you. You have to catch up now, Rick. Here we go. Sam said, when I was a kid, we were so poor.
How poor were we?
You must learn to pick up your cues. You must be alert at every moment. We were so poor we couldn't afford to feed a big watchdog. Instead, we had a watch blank. Couldn't afford to feed a big watchdog, so we had a watch blank.
Yo.
You got it.
Got it.
Let's see if Rick gets it. Sam said, when I was a kid, we were so poor we couldn't afford to feed a big watchdog. Instead, we had a watch blank.
Rat.
Watch rat.
Watch rat.
Watch rat. Watch rat.
Good.
Okay.
Watch rat.
Watch rat. That's what he wants. What do you say?
There again, having some... You're as bald as I am, watch it.
Not quite, Deke.
Well, he does it that way, I do it that way.
Oh, I see.
Anyway, ducks are very good, and I said duck. Watch duck as they quack in place
of...
Jump in the canal.
Gene, I'm a little worried about Mr. Rutherford.
Yes. I'm worried about the whole mob here. Okay,
you got to worry a lot more about me because I heard watch, and I figured you could feed him with somebody else's dog if he had a watch tick. Because watch is tick.
I'm really worried about the beaver.
Boy, you know, hey, Gene.
I'm really worried about the beaver. That was really something.
The beaver's
tick, tick, watches tick.
You were in show business at one time?
What do you mean, were?
I know, I beg your pardon.
Remember Dallas.
All right, okay, gotcha. Holla, Ken.
Listen, if you're going to have something to watch your house, it's got to be ferocious, right? What is more ferocious than a goldfish?
Goldfish, yeah. Right there.
Oh, give him some treatment, kids. Come on.
Hey, that's a good answer. I like ticks.
Hey, I'm a little worried about Eddie Haskell, Gene.
Worried about the whole Cleaver tribe.
I'm actually even a little worried about this answer. I have to leave it in the hands of the judges because I said mouse.
No, let's leave it to Beaver.
Ha!
Yeah! What is a rat a mouse?
May I, understand that logic or mind not to question.
Rat's a mouse.
What's a small
any small household pest?
A rodent's a rodent.
Okay, all right.
Is a household pest.
Okay, Rich.
From watchdog, I wanted to go the opposite way, from biggest to smallest, so I said a mouse.
Great.
Four is now tied, 2-2.
Well, I thought that Richard's answer was the dumbest, and I thought this was a dumb show, so I put duck.
All right.
A little worried about Gallagher, but that's not new.
So there's the end of round two. The score is tied 2-2 at the end of round two. Round three, final round after this.
Answer?
Thank you.
All right, here we go with round three. This is the final round, and I'll push a button and reveal the questions. And since we're tied 2-2, let's see now. You went first last time?
Yes.
You go first this time.
I'll take a B this time.
What? Is that right? Yeah.
Listen, I'm in charge. When I say it's this way, that's the way it is. He went first, she went first, second. He goes first to third because it's tied, right? Don't argue with me, I'm a star.
Yeah.
What?
That's right.
What do you want?
B.
B. Okay, I got it.
All right.
Go, star.
All right. Louie's restaurant is so sleazy.
L-C-D-S-S.
You're hired.
Got that.
The menu is written on blank.
Oh, too bad. That's such a good answer.
You don't run down. Gene, what the idea is, see, if you have a watch duck,
yeah,
then when you hear a quack, you know somebody's in your yard. You hear a bark at somebody else's. See, it's actually a very good idea.
Very good.
Very good.
Yeah.
I have my answer for this one.
Back in the cage. All right. Ready over there. No, Richard and Jerry not ready.
I didn't.
All right, now we're ready. Ready? Okay, Rick. Louie's restaurant is so sleazy, the menu is written on blank.
A garbage can.
Ah.
Rick.
Lid.
You just
garbage
blew it.
Probably.
Want to wish you well? Anyway, he says a garbage can. I don't think it's going to happen. It's not bad, but...
Maybe Richard.
Not inspired. Richard. Louie's restaurant is so sleazy, the menu is written on...
Well, I didn't want to go the whole route. I said tea paper, which I thought was rather...
Okay.
Well, I figured they would have ticks for waiters, and they'd use garbage pail tops.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait. Hold it. Wait a minute. Show this to the judge. Hold it up there and be proud of it.
Hey. All right.
Rick.
Leave it to Beaver.
Excellent.
I eat humble pie.
Yeah,
no problem.
I eat crow. I, never
eat
mind.
In the wrong places, don't you?
Yes, I do. All right, Ken.
Rick, I kind of felt like Gene did about your answer, but, you know, the dummy here can do it one. Yeah, it's written on a napkin.
On a napkin. All right, that would be sleazy. You don't write, we come to you, Gallagher.
I don't think that was sleazy. Napkins are not sleazy. What's sleazy is writing it on a fly swatter.
That's it.
And they're using it as a spatula.
How about the restaurant was so sleazy, the menu was written on Louis, you know, on his apron, you know, hash, toast, all that.
Ask the next question.
Never.
Keep hosting. Keep hosting, star.
Okay.
What about you?
Now, Jerry, you need one to tie and two to win.
Oh, don't write.
Who plays? Jerry does not play. John doesn't play. The rest of you, please respond to this. You play. Often?
No.
No.
That's why I haven't been caught.
Oh. Beaver Cleaver said.
Uh-oh.
Wow. He'll know that one.
I'm going to get this
one. Listen. I don't do a Beaver Cleaver imitation, so we've got to do that. You do the stuff in quotes, and I'll do the narrative stuff. Beaver Cleaver said.
Boy, that Eddie Haskell is such a sneak. He even cheated on a...
blank.
Test.
All right.
He's got it.
I have never cheated on a test in my life.
Boy, that Eddie Haskell is such a sneak, he even cheated on a blank test. Okay? You understand? Okay. Come on, Haskell, you ready?
Hey, I'm ready.
Okay.
Push it in.
All right. Beaver Cleaver said, boy, that Eddie Haskell is such a sneak. He even cheated on a blank test.
Eye
test. That's a good one. A couple of good answers here. Eye test is one of the good ones.
I think this is a good one. Blood test.
Very good.
Oh.
Eye test and blood test are the really two good responses here. What do you say, Ken?
Well, we're all in the same ballpark.
Physical test? Yeah, that's another good one. You don't play? What do you have to say about all that?
Well, I felt the same way about the old blood test.
All right. Scores at 3-2. Now, you must match Gallagher to achieve a tie and stay in the game, Jerry. What have you got?
Well, what do you mean? What has Jerry got? She's got slim chance of none, doesn't
she? Well, she's
not an enviable position.
Hoping you're going to say I.
I?
Say I.
No, I'm going to say Pap. Pap.
All right, come on down, Rick Hoffman. You win the game. Come on down. Now, Jerry, it was a pleasure to have you here. Match Game is going to send some gifts your way. Many thanks for being here on the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Jerry Kimber, what do you say? All right. Now,
time to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring on three more celebrities. Here comes the rest of the set. And John Bauman will be hosting Hollywood Squares. I'm going to change seats with him. We've got lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Ward's 25-inch portable color TV, 130-channel capability, remote control, direct random access tuning, and mute volume control. Furnished by Montgomery Ward. And now it's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Power. With more of our tribute to Leave It to Beaver. With Barbara Billingsley as June Cleaver. Jerry Weil as Judy. Frank Frank as Lumpy. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Okay, we'll be right back. You come back to it. Welcome to the second half of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. And here he is, Officer Rick Hoffman from Seal Beach, whose opponent found herself in the position of having to match Gallagher to tie. And that's it's not the most enviable position conceivably. So that Rick has made his way into the Hollywood Squares. We also have three brand new celebrities. We have Lumpy Rutherford.
Yeah.
We have Judy Hessler. Is that right? Is that the right name?
Hensler.
Hensler.
Yes.
Oh, it's real close. And, of course, we have Mama June Cleaver. June Cleaver, also known as Barbara Billingsley. It's been a long time, really, since you've done the Leave It to Beaver show. After all these years, how do you feel about that guy, the Beaver?
John? I'm worried about the Beaver.
Well, some things never change. And right about this time, one of the things that never changes is that we're going to go play Hollywood Squares. Here we go.
All right!
Cindy Charbonneau is the name of our defending champion. We will reacquaint ourselves, and we will reacquaint ourselves with her bankroll, which has now reached the mammoth proportion of $35,850. Not too bad. I'm going to ask you really a loaded question that we haven't asked you. We put two contestants on the spot the first day, but were you a big fan of Leave It to Beaver?
I watched it weekly, yeah.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, have you watched it since it's been... You know, the Leave It to Beaver has really not been off the air. Is this correct, or am I making this up, guys? That it has really not been off the air for any appreciable length of time since the shows were done in 1963, right?
It's a lie. True, you're right. Making it up.
I think that's true, and you can pretty much catch it every day. But don't catch it right now, because it's time to play Hollywood Squares, which we're going to play until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point is, of course, the winner, goes on to play Super Match for up to $30,000. And our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square either of them captures. And our champion always gets to start, which is you once again, Cindy. Pick a star. Let's go.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
I'm ready for you, my
Gene Lumpy Rayburn.
Right.
Gene. Which is the most popular flavor of ice cream in the U.S.?
Is that it?
That's it. No choices. They think you can figure this out all by yourself.
It's a very difficult question for me because I am a chocolate-holic. I would kill for chocolate. I mean, if he had an ice cream cone right now, a chocolate ice cream cone, I would
just
and eat it all up.
Just answer it. Yes. It doesn't have to kill.
All right. So, I say chocolate.
There are some chocoholics who agree. Agree or disagree, Cindy, that chocolate is the most popular flavor of ice cream?
I agree.
Vanilla, it is. Ah. No, you should have disagreed. And more people like vanilla. See, almost 3-1 over chocolate. The first square goes to your opponent, who is on the board. Now, where would you like to put your O on your own, Rick?
I like the Beaver.
Don't we all?
Go for it.
Okay, Beav. In a recent Psychology Today survey, Americans were asked if there is anything better than sex. Did most of them say there is something better, or did they say that sex is the best thing there is?
Chocolate.
Vanilla, guys.
3-1.
Vanilla, 3-1.
If you get this one wrong, you're really in trouble.
Uh-oh.
Squirt.
I think it's been around a long time. I don't think they've found anything better.
Agree or disagree, Rick, that
sex.
Most Americans say there's nothing
better than sex.
What
that is.
I'm disagree. What is it used for?
Hold on. This guy's playing a game. What are you going to say?
I'm going to disagree.
He's going to disagree. And, you know, you are right to disagree. Most say that there is something better than sex. Yes.
But they don't
you get
say
the square.
They don't say what it is.
They have examples.
What?
There are examples, such as candy.
No.
Ice cream.
No.
Wrong.
This one is really good, though. Hugging and kissing.
Wrong!
But that's sex.
Girls, they ask girls.
Cindy, take a good look at this board. And if you can still remember what game we're playing, pick a star for me.
June DeBlock, please.
Right. You missed this one. The first game will belong to Rick. June Cleaver. Benjamin Franklin invented a certain piece of sports equipment. Was it the athletic supporter? Or the swim fin?
Oh, I think he was out in the rain, wasn't he, with the lightning and stuff? Swim fin.
Hey, Beav, I'm worried about Mom.
So am I. I'm real worried about it, Gallagher.
Okay, logic doesn't count in this game. You know, it's just either the right answer or the wrong answer. She says that Benjamin Franklin invented the swim fin to block. Do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Benjamin Franklin invented the swim fin. No, you should have agreed with her. Your opponent gets the square, wins the first game. A clean sweep. Oh, for Officer Rick, got 3 O's in a row, and we'll be back with a $200 game after these messages. You all come back too. More fun.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
On the next...
Back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Okay, welcome to Match Game Hollywood Squares Soap Opera Hour. And the real question is burning in all of our minds. Will Cindy Charbonneau soon have lots more time to watch Leave It to Beaver? Because she is a little bit behind. She has nothing so far. She is our defending champion, but she does have the chance to pick the first star in this game.
The Beaver, please.
Jerry Mathers. A woman walks by wearing nothing but a great perfume.
Nothing?
Nothing.
But she doesn't prefer sex, right? Psychologist today said no, she wants candy. Go on.
You know those psychologists. A woman walks by wearing nothing but a great perfume, Jerry. According to 17 magazine, what are you likely to remember longer? The way she looked or the way she smelled?
Smear some chocolate ice cream on her, baby.
That's right. I would say that you would probably be so shocked that the scent would be a very strong thing, and I think you'd probably remember how she smelled.
Spelled?
Sure. That's a toughie. I mean,
Beaver says you remember how she smelled, Cindy. Agree or disagree for the first square in this game?
I agree.
The way she smelled, it is. You're right to agree, and you get on the board. Okay, she's on the board, but it's your move. Where would you like to place this O, Mr. Hoffman?
I would like to place it with Mr. Gallagher.
All right.
First time he's ever been called that. Gallagher, in New York City, which costs more?
Sex. Followed
That's
by
it, yes.
Chocolate.
It says sex or chocolate ice cream.
Okay.
In New York City, which costs more, a marriage license or a license for your dog?
License for your... Well, that's the same thing. In New York City! In New York...
Quick, isn't he?
Your dog.
He says a license for your dog costs more
But you
than
have me. To curb your wife.
But 1 second, I'm going to have to curb you. He says a license for your dog costs more than a marriage license in New York City. Agree or disagree, Rick?
I agree.
A marriage license costs more than a license for your dog. No,
I know. He's
you should
a policeman,
have disagreed.
I didn't want to do.
And I'll tell you why. A marriage license costs $10 and a dog license costs $8.50. So there.
Big deal, a buck and a half.
Okay. Cindy Charbonneau, you got 2 X's up there already, and now it's your move.
Lumpy to win, please.
This could do it. Frank Bank, alias
Lumpy. Told you they'd ask me a question.
This is your first Hollywood Squares question the whole
this
week.
This is it. This is it for the win, yeah. Come
okay, on. Lumpy. In the past year, you've eaten 120 pounds of potatoes.
I knew it. I knew they'd come up with a food question.
Frank,
and you haven't given him a bald
question. You didn't know how lucky you were not to get any questions. In the past year, you've eaten 120 pounds of potatoes. Does this mean you're about average? Or are you a real pig?
120 pounds of potatoes, 360 days a year. That's 6 ounces a day. You're about average. I'm a potato expert. I didn't get this way by looking at it. Remember that. You ought to know.
For the game,
right.
Cindy, agree or disagree average. That 120 pounds of potatoes is about average for a year?
I agree.
You are about average. You are right to agree. You get the square. You forge from behind and won the game. Did the same thing yesterday. She comes from behind. Okay, it's 275 to 175. However, all is not complete. Let us clear the board and move on to the next game. And this one is worth $300.
All right.
It's close. Every $25 counts. Okay, Rick, your move to pick a square.
The Beaver.
Okay. Right.
Jerry Mathers, the toilet our astronauts used on the space shuttle had an unusual piece of equipment. Was it a computerized flusher? Or a seat belt?
Now you got the right guy.
Yeah. A lid. They needed a lid. They should have a lid.
That's an easy one with no gravity out there. Of course they had to have a seat belt. Who needs a computer when you can have a seat belt?
Agree or disagree, Rick, that the toilet had a seat belt?
I agree.
A seat belt it is. A seat belt on the space shuttle, you get the square. Please, we have to break for commercial, but not before this important piece of information. There is no flusher. There is no flusher. Instead, the waste goes through a shredder and is then thrown up against a blower.
Settle down.
Let's see. Well, we got a big O behind the Beav and Cindy. It is your turn. Pick a star.
Mr. Rutherford, please.
Mr. Rutherford. We all know that fleas are great jumpers. But can your average flea jump over 6 chihuahuas laid end to end? Or will it crash onto one of the dogs? Gallagher liked my reading.
I have a dog at home that is Benji's sister. And the only problem I have with my dog, whose name is Face, is the fleas. And man, they could jump over 50 chihuahuas. The answer is yes.
You figured out, John.
Okay, Cindy, he says yes. Agree or disagree? No, I have to clear this up for you. You're trying to say that it can jump over, your average flea can jump over 6 chihuahuas laid end to end.
Yes.
See, he knew it was yes all along. Okay, Cindy, he says that the average flea can do this. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
The average flea will crash. No, you should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square and $25. Fleas jump 13 inches lengthwise. 6 chihuahuas stretch out to about 42 inches.
You can't lay down chihuahuas and air.
Okay, Rick, let's get back to the game. Pick a star.
Eddie to win, please.
Right.
John.
Richard.
Does Rick know that Eddie up here is another police officer? This is going to be interesting to see how the two policemen...
Listen, whatever I tell you, it's good information. I'm smart.
See how they communicate here.
He knows it now, but he probably doesn't care because he'd rather win the game before the time's up, Bell. So here we go. Ken Osman, you're a person who laughs at sick jokes. According to Dr. Joyce Brothers, should you seek psychiatric help? Or are you just cheerful?
Actually, I think you're normal.
Here's one now.
Being a policeman, I'm normal. I laugh at sick stuff. Yeah, I think you're normal when you do that. Yeah.
So,
I think you're normal when you
you're normal. Okay, you're just cheerful, in other words. Yeah. Rick, he says you're just cheerful if you laugh at sick jokes for the game and the lead. Do you agree or disagree?
I agree.
You are just cheerful. You are right to agree, and you get the square and win the game. into the lead. 275 for our defending champion. We are ready to play another game. This one is going to be worth $400. Rick, you won the last game. As we know, that means Cindy gets to start. Pick a star.
Clear Beaver, the board, please.
Pardon me?
The Beaver, please.
Okay, Beave.
I got my seatbelt on. I'm ready.
According to a survey by the University of Michigan, who spends more of their work day actually doing work, men or women?
Oh, you're going to make me a sexist, huh? Gee, I don't know why. I think I'm going to say women.
Agree or disagree that women spend more of their work day actually doing work, Cindy?
I disagree.
Women, it is. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets the first square in this game and $25. Okay, Officer Hoffman, place
okay,
your O.
Okay, I think I'll place it with Eddie again.
Hey, trust me, trust me.
I do.
Officer Haskell, which came first, Fresca or Squirt?
Thanks, Squirt.
Well, I'll tell you, I can remember the Fresca when it first came out, and I can't remember Squirt when it first came out, so
he's
I got
right next to you.
I gotta say Squirt. Squirt.
Agree or disagree, Rick, that Squirt came before Fresca?
I agree.
Squirt it was. You were right to agree, and you get another square. And the bell means the time is up. You have done it, Officer Rick Hoffman. $600. You're a new champ. Well done. Not bad. Okay, this is your first time. Means you get to go over and join Gene Rayburn, get set for your first chance at the big money. Hold it up, everybody, because we have a tender moment. We have to say goodbye to someone that we have gotten to know pretty well because she's been here a very long time, Cindy Charbonneau. She is leaving here with more than our thanks. She's leaving here with a total of $36,125. And, of course, our best good wishes and thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares. Congratulations. Okay, and now while we continue to hold hands, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go. Congratulations here. And we're going to be back with the champ here and our nine celebrities for a go at the big money right after this.
Answer?
Stakes.com right now.
Now, here to play the Supermatch is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much, Gene Wood. Well, how do you feel?
I couldn't tell you. I'm excited.
Well, we're very excited for you. We wish you the very best of luck here in this Supermatch. You can win up to $30,000. Let's have a go at it. We polled a recent studio audience, said write down your best answer to this. Monty Blank. If you choose the answer that they wrote down most frequently, it's $1,000 for you. Second most popular answer is $500, and the third pays $250. Any three of the six stars can assist here, and you may call on them one at a time. Who do you want to call on?
Lumpy.
Oh, have I got a deal? Monty Hall.
Monty Hall, all right.
John.
Monty Python.
Monty Python.
Eddie.
I guess I'm getting older than I really... Monty Montana.
Monty Montana.
Does that make me pretty old?
All right. So you got Monty Montana, Monty Python, and Monty Hall. Those are the three they've given you. Now you may choose one of theirs or dream up one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I'm going to take Lumpy's answer.
Lumpy said. Monty Hall. Let's find out if Monty Hall is up there, and if so, where. We'll begin down at the bottom. Let's slide the $250 response. Monty Montana.
It wasn't so dumb.
Wow, it was very good. Mighty good. All right, let's take a look at the $500 response. Monty Python.
Got it.
Okay. He's going for Monty Hall. Let's find out if it's up there. Go. Yeah. Monty, Monty, Monty. Remember that routine? Oh, that was so fun. Okay, now you've got $1,000. You're going to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing here. And remember, when you choose a star, that star will reveal the number in front of him. It'll be a 10, 20, or a 30. We'll multiply your $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. Time now to make your pick.
I'm going to go with Eddie.
Eddie.
Hey, yeah. you stick with me, Rick. We're going to do all right.
Okay. Huh? All right, Eddie, grab the tab and give it a yank.
Got to be a 30. Got to be a 30.
10 it is. That means you're playing for $10,000. $10,000 is okay, right? Right.
You can write any of them without the
10,000. Good luck to you. Face me if you would, please. All right, here we go. Blank wash. W-A-S-H. Blank wash. All right, Eddie's ready. Now, Rick, it's up to you to match him. If you do, you get the $10,000. What do you say to match Eddie?
White.
Whitewash. All right. Eddie, he says whitewash will match him for the $10,000. What do you say to that?
I say that was my second choice.
I'm sorry. Whitewash?
You're off the force.
I mean, you thought of whitewash. And
I thought of whitewash.
You debated between whitewash and car wash.
Yeah.
And then you put car wash. I think they're both very good answers, and it was a difficult decision. Listen, you've got a total of $1,600, and you're going to come back. You may be in the same spot again tomorrow. Who knows? Come back right after these messages.
Or go to mezzobook.com.
Here we go. Listen, we want to find out which of the celebrities had the big 3-0. So, John, if you'll help us here.
Sure.
Everybody will take the tab and give it a yank.
Go.
Judy had it.
Ah. And she didn't get called out from one screen the entire
Judy,
game.
Didn't you play Hollywood Squares at all?
Didn't say a
Richard,
word.
Richard, did you?
And
you didn't either.
Nah.
Oh.
We didn't even get to say her name, Jerry Weil.
What do you say?
Or Lumpy's name, Frank Bank.
I tell you what, since you didn't get called on, Richard, here's a $5 bill.
Judy, we're going to dinner.
Judy. Split it with Judy.
Judy. Yeah,
you got any money?
No,
for
I'm
Judy.
Sorry. That's it. Gene Rayburn
nothing
here.
Nothing for any of us either, is it?
Inviting you to join us tomorrow for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
And John Bonnet saying so long. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Jules Jurgensen elegantly styled watches, ladies' quartz analog with rectangular case, 6 diamonds and mesh bracelet, plus a gents' quartz analog day-date in a carrot-clad case with matching bracelet, furnished by Jules Jurgensen. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.